Hello and welcome to Java Interview Questions and Answers Part 2. Let us get started. Question 11. How can you add GUI elements to a Java application? Java has an API called Swing to provide GUI components such as text boxes, check boxes, radio buttons, combo boxes, and so on. These components are available on importing javax.swing.star. The process to add a GUI element to a Java application is: first, create a new object of the component class. Second, add the object to the container. And three, attach an event handler to the object. Question 12. How can you accept user input to a Java application? This can be done by importing the java.util.scanner class. The scanner class has methods like nextInt, nextDouble, nextLine, and so on to accept inputs of different data types from the user into a variable. Question 13. What methods are available to search within a string? The string class in Java has a vast number of methods. There are many methods to search for characters within a string. Examples of these methods include char@, contains, index of, last index of, starts with, and ends with. Question 14. How do you draw graphics in a Java application? Java has a built-in graphics object. This object has methods such as drawArc, drawImage, drawLine, drawRect for an empty rectangle, fillRect for a solid rectangle, drawPolygon, fillPolygon, and so on. These methods can be invoked to draw the respective lines and shapes in any desired color. Question 15. How can you work with files and folders in Java? First, import the java.io.file library. Then create an object of the file class. We can point the file object to the required file or directory. This object will have files properties and methods. A scanner object can be created for the file object and used to fetch the contents in the file. Question 16. In Java, how do you handle exceptions? This is done with try and catch blocks. So there may be code which, if executed, may throw an exception. Such code is put inside a try block, which is followed by a catch block containing the exception handler. If the code throws an exception when it is executed, the control flows to the catch block. The try block may have one or more lines of code. Each line of code may have its own try block also. There can be one or more catch blocks to handle different types of exceptions. All such catch blocks immediately follow the try block. Question 17. What is recursion? A recursive method is one that calls itself. Let us look at the example below. Now, here, for a given integer input that is greater than 1, this method sums all the integers from the input down to 1. Now, let us say for this method, we give the input argument as 2. So it is going to add up all the numbers from 1 to 2. That is, 1 plus 2 is 3. So first, if the input is 2, it checks. If 2 is equal to 1, no, it goes to the else block, return 2 plus sum all 2 minus 1, which means the sum all method calls itself. And this time it calls itself with an input argument of 1. Now when the input argument is 1, it returns 1. So basically it returns 2 plus 1, that is 3. Now there are a couple of items to note here. If n is equal to 1, return 1. This is the base case, which is where the recursion ends. And here, since we have the function calling itself, there is recursion in this line of code. Question 18. What is the benefit of using a list instead of an array? The collection class has several useful methods that work on a list but do not work on an array. Some of these methods are add all, binary search, copy, fill, max, min, reverse, shuffle and sort. Question 19. How are stack and priority queue classes different? First, the stack. A new element can be added to the stack by the push method. The new element is always added at the top of the stack. In an existing stack, the top element can be removed by the pop method. The stack method has other methods to add and remove elements at specified positions within the stack. Now the priority queue class. In a priority queue, a new element is added by the offer method. This new element is always inserted at the bottom of the queue. In an existing queue, the top element can be removed by using the poll method. The queue does not have methods to add and remove elements at specified positions within the queue. Question 20. How can different code in a program be executed concurrently? That means at the same time. This can be done using threads. A Java application can have multiple threads of execution running at the same time. A thread can be created by writing a class that implements a runnable interface, which means we have to implement the run method of this interface. Thereafter, a new thread can be created by instantiating a new thread object. A thread object has a number of methods like set priority and start. That is all in this video. Thank you and see you in my other videos.